Refrigerant is used in devices that can remove heat like AC and fridge. Refrigerant can be in gas or liquid state depending on the temperature. The important job of refrigerant is to absorb the heat in the area where we want to cool. Initially, dangerous refrigerants like ammonia, sulfur dioxide, methyl chloride were used in AC and fridges. When such a dangerous refrigerant leaks, it causes more danger to the bystanders. It can even cause death. Thus, the first non-flammable R12 refrigerant was invented and used in 1928. Chlorofluorocarbon chemical is used in this R12 refrigerant. In 1980, it became known that this chlorofluorocarbon chemical is damaging the ozone layer severely. That is, when 1 kg of R12 refrigerant leaks, it causes the same damage as 10 tons of carbon dioxide. So, they banned the buying and selling of R12 refrigerant after that. Now, R12 refrigerant is not manufactured anywhere. R410A, R134 refrigerants were invented instead of these refrigerants. Hydrofluorocarbon chemical is used in these refrigerants. It does not affect the ozone layer. Now this refrigerant is being used in most AC and fridges. A refrigerant must have certain properties. Its important properties are: boiling point should be low. There should be high critical temperature and high latent heat. There should be high thermal conductivity. Should not cause any harm to the materials. Must not be flammable or explosive. Should not be poisonous. Should be cheap and readily available. There should be no harm to ozone layer and the environment. Now, let's see how refrigerant works in an AC unit. The boiling point of R410A refrigerant is minus 45 degrees Celsius. That means, it starts to boil at minus 45 degrees Celsius. If we put it in our hand, it will start boiling at the temperature of the hand. This refrigerant travels through all the equipment in the AC unit. First, let's see from the evaporator. Evaporator is the indoor unit of AC. When the refrigerant travels through the coil, the fan blower behind the coil continues to blow air. Then, due to the heat in this air, the refrigerant inside the coil will boil and turn into vapor. The cooling in the refrigerant will be transferred to the air. Then, this refrigerant goes inside the compressor. Refrigerant is in low pressure, high temperature, and vapor state before entering the compressor. After the refrigerant enters the compressor compresses the refrigerant well and sends it out at high pressure. Only then, this refrigerant can travel through all the equipments. When it comes out of the compressor, the refrigerant is in high pressure, high temperature, and vapor state. This compressor is inside the outdoor. After compressor, it goes to condenser. Condenser is coil in outdoor. When the refrigerant travels through this coil, the fan that is behind the coil blows air and the temperature of the refrigerant decreases. Thus, when the temperature of the refrigerant decreases, the refrigerant changes from the vapor state to the liquid state. Therefore, when the refrigerant comes out of the condenser, it is in high pressure, low temperature, and liquid state. Then finally, the refrigerant goes inside the expansion valve. When the refrigerant passes through the expansion valve, its pressure will decrease. Due to decrease in pressure, its temperature also decreases a lot. In our last video, we explained about how expansion valve works. Its link is in the description. Those who need it, watch the video. Now, when the refrigerant comes out from the expansion valve, It will be at low pressure, very low temperature, and liquid state. Then, it goes back into the evaporator. Thus, it will continue. So, in this video, I hope you understand what refrigerant is, its history, characteristics, and the states of refrigerant in an AC unit. If you have any doubt, ask in comments. If you think this video will be useful to anyone, please share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our Zebra Learnings English channel. Thank you.